Let's go back to the main activity of our Just Java app. Specifically, we were looking at the display message method and trying to figure out everything that was going on in here. Even though the findViewById method is not declared within this class, we know now that it's actually defined in the superclass in the AppCompat activity. Same for setContentView. This is defined within the AppCompat activity class. But what exactly is happening in this method, and why do we need to pass in a resource ID, and why do we have extra parentheses here? To answer that question, I'm going to summarize everything we've learned so far and lead you to why this code exists here. Do you remember this diagram? When you click on the app icon on the device, it opens up the main activity. Within our code, the onCreate method of the main activity gets called by the system. Within this method, we have a method called to setContentView with the resource layout ID. In an earlier exercise, we passed in a single text view for setContentView, but we want more than one view for our app, so we pass in a layout resource ID. This maps to an XML file. Once we set the content view, the activity goes and finds the XML layout file and then reads through each line. For each view, it inflates or creates a Java object for it. It goes through the XML file and then builds up this whole hierarchy of Java objects. When it's inflating each of these views, it's actually calling the constructor, new text view or new linear layout, and then it's passing in all these attributes into the Java object so that it can be set up properly. Notice that we didn't have to write code for new text view or new linear layout and to set the font size. All of it was handled by the inflation process of the activity. To interact with these views while the app is running and to change them, for example, to change the text or to change the buttons, then we need to find these Java objects. Once we find them, we can store them as variables in the main activity. Remember, we're not creating new text views from scratch, we're just finding the existing ones in this view hierarchy. These are the variables we've used so far in the main activity. We have a variable for quantity, price, and price message. This is a mix of local and global variables. To interact with the views in the view hierarchy, we should create variables that reference these specific views. For example, we can create a variable called quantityTextView that would refer to this text view here. If you click on the plus or minus buttons in the UI, then you can change the text view text to show a different number. We can also have a variable called orderSummaryTextView that points to this text view. When you click on the order button, then the order summary text view will change its text to show the new order summary. So you can see how having variables that point to some of these views would be useful for changing the UI when the app is running. But how do we make the connection between this variable here to this text view? And how do we make the connection between order summary text view here and this text view? Back in the layout XML file, remember that we assigned view IDs to certain views? For this text view, we gave it a view ID of quantity text view. For this view, we gave it an ID order summary text view. It's optional to assign IDs to views, and you only should assign a view ID if you need to refer to that view later. For example, you can assign view IDs to everything, but that's unnecessary. We only really need to refer to these two views later in our Java code, so let's just assign IDs to these two views. Okay, we've established that views have view IDs so that we can refer to them later in the Java code. We also established that we want variables that point to these views so that we can manipulate these views. But we still don't exactly know how to make the connection between this variable and this specific Java object. And same for this variable and this Java object. In the AppCompat activity class, I want to show you a specific method. It's called findViewById, and it takes as input a resource ID. The findViewById method finds a view that corresponds with the ID that is passed as an input. And the activity searches for this view in the view hierarchy from the XML that was processed in the onCreate method. So like I was mentioning earlier, the activity onCreate method sets up a view hierarchy, and then the findViewById method goes and finds a view within that view hierarchy. The return value of this method is an object of type view. This left-hand column shows a return value for all of these methods. This means that within our activity code, we can call findViewById, pass in the resource ID of the view that we want, and then it will return a view object, and then we can store that as a variable within the activity. The main activity Java code would look like this. We can call findViewById and then pass in as an input the resource ID of the view that we want. We gave this text view an ID of order summary text view, so here we reference it as r.id.orderSummaryTextView. This method will go and traverse the whole view hierarchy and then look for the view with this ID. Then it will return this Java object as the return value of this method. We can store the return value into this variable on the left-hand side called orderSummaryTextView, and this is a variable of type view. So this returns a view, and we store it inside a view variable. Later in the main activity, we can also call findViewById and then pass in this resource ID, r.id.quantityTextView, which refers to this text view here. This is a text view in the quantity picker. When this is called, the activity will search through the view hierarchy and then try to find the view with this ID. And then it will return this view, and then we can store that in a variable called quantityTextView. This variable also has a data type of view. This explains how you can have a quantityTextView and orderSummaryTextView variables within the main activity, and that these variables can connect to these Java objects in the view hierarchy. By the way, I listed the data types here of each of these variables in the left-hand column. So these two variables have a type view, as declared here.